that tour was really interesting, don't you think?
It's been 15 years since the tragedy in Asheville, so I want to run a front-page story about it for the paper, and I want you to write it. Go to Asheville and learn everything you can about what really happened back in 85. And remember, facts, facts, facts!
This job will kill me one day.
Howdy, I'm Ben. I own the place. Well, your car suffered big time. I tell you what, you're lucky you made it here. This area ain't friendly to visitors. So, you a reporter? Hear about the mines, huh? Yeah, I still feel the effects of that explosion today. There are new cracks all the time. The sky is full of ash. You ain't the first reporter around here, you know. Most of them started Robert Lawson's apartment. Lawson was a local historian. He gathered books and whatnot. The address is 13 Blue Pine Street. Here's the nozzle. Go ahead and fill up your tank, but keep it moving. I still got work to do here.
Hello? Is anyone here?
Yeah. severe condition in the mines took the lives of workers and civilians. A short circuit caused a fire that employees armed with extinguishers were unable to put out. Jonathan Bradley, the mine's owner, took medicine to the victim's families. He was put in but released when it was ruled an accident. Showed flawed calculations of the mine's depth, but all the taken after the explosion were entered into police evidence. The damage was widespread, forcing locals to evacuate their homes. Rumors persist that the blame lies on Bradley. His critics allege that he ignored safety regulations for and the arson was committed to cover his.
It's the evening news on Main Radio 103.6 FM. FEMA is issuing a warning to residents about heavy rains tonight. Be careful and don't leave your home unless absolutely necessary, especially for people in the Asheville area, as flooding may cause road surfaces to fragment.
Lucky you came along. Thanks. I'm Nathan, the reporter from Channel 6. We're doing a story about the explosion. Did the guy from the gas station send you here? Same here. He said a historian lived there. I tried to get inside, but this bus is blocking the door. And then those dogs showed up. Let's work together to get inside. If you help me, I'll share some of what I recorded. Here, I thought this might be useful.
Thank you.
You open the door, and I'll knock them out. What's this? Well, it's a diary, but it's empty. I was excited for a second there.
May 4th, 1985. Explosion in mines. The town starts collapsing. The facts suggest that it was Jonathan Bradley's fault.
What the? Who's writing this? An explosion? But today's May 4th.
Good night, Miss Mitchell. No one can know the truth.
What was that? Whoever it is, maybe they'll write back. Jonathan Bradley bought this block of apartments for further mining. We have 2 days to evacuate, but no one wants to leave their homes, so the residents are all going to protest Bradley's plans. No reply.
Hey, Robert, are you still at home? You need to get to the bowling club. The protest is starting.
Officer, I have a gift for you, between you and me. I hope you can keep this protest small. There's more where that came from if we can avoid any media interference as well.
I understand, Mr. Bradley. You can count on me. Hold up there. I'm afraid there are too many protesters already. I can't let any more people join. That noise. Ugh. The last thing I need right now is a fire.
Thank you all for coming out. We can't let Bradley take our homes and ruin our beautiful Asheville. He doesn't understand that more mines would be a disaster. These lands are prone to sinkholes.
Friends, I'm glad that the Asheville citizens care about this town, but I assure you, there's no need to worry. Miss Lawson, let's go inside for some coffee and I'll show you that our geological calculations are completely sound. It won't take long.
Thank you.
Your ticket, please.
Hello, Robert. The entire Lawson family decided to visit today. I just spoke with your sister, and we came to an understanding on the new mines. I understand your frustration at losing your home, but believe me, I will offer you something better. I know you don't trust me. I tell you what, how about we bowl a few frames to calm down? As your sister. Even a pestering historian should understand that money is the ultimate problem solver.
Oh, Ben! My car broke down and I was attacked. Can you please call my boss? I can't get a signal on my phone.
Oh, my! Of course! I warned you that Asheville was unfriendly. Now you're gonna see how much the truth hurts.
Marshall, the refrigerator at my bowling club needs cleaning. It's a, special job. Yeah, your company is the only one I trust cleaning up this kind of trash.
Robert, you're alive! One of Bradley's mines just exploded. Asheville is about to collapse. We have to go!
Hold on, Cheryl. I'll save you.
A catastrophic explosion in one of Jonathan Bradley's mines has rocked Asheville. Reports of severe property damage and casualties are flooding in.
Everything is as predicted. This explosion wasn't an accident. How do I know? My name is Gladys. I'm a fortune teller. Let's discuss what troubles you. Please, prepare a cup of coffee for me, and then sit. The coffee grounds will reveal the answers. Do you see the eye? It's the sign of a life-changing gift. Not something like a sweater or a book, but something mysterious. Look, the symbol of a drum. That means that you already have this gift. Your diary. It can reach through time and send a message to the past. The tree symbolizes changes. It's in your hands to change these events. And the chain means that you'll do it together with someone else. You'll need the courage and tenacity of an eagle to succeed. But the crown indicates that you'll be rewarded in the end. And could that reward be true love?
This is your fault, Bradley. Look at what you've done to Asheville. You never cared for this town. You only care about money. I'm going to bring you to justice.
No, you won't. I can silence you. Forever.
Follow me to my store. We'll be safe there. My name is Gladys. That was close. You came too close to the truth and almost paid for it. Look at this. Nathan is really Jonathan Bradley. He left Asheville after the explosion. Nobody knew about his new life. He came back last year. Under his new name. He wants to get rid of any evidence of his fault in the explosion. It's up to you to stop Bradley and undo this tragedy. Look into my mirror of time. It's broken, but I believe you can repair it. If you find the tarot cards, I can read them for you. Just bring me the translator. Don't be afraid. These are the miners that haunt Asheville. They mean no harm. Thank you. Wait. Remember, you can't touch anyone in the past. It could cause time itself to collapse. The mirror only shows important events. You'll have to go through and learn why this moment is important for you. Tarot cards don't lie, as you'll find out. A pair of jesters indicate important changes. Your life will never be the same. The cards of a wise maiden suggest that you recognize your dreams and thoughts. They may be prophetic. The winged chariots mean a long mental journey in the past. With your diary, it may be literal in this case. The wizards show the power you have to change events across different periods, if you try. the lovers. Combined with the previous cards, it shows that your love is far away. In time, if not location. But don't worry. The moon will light your way and help you deal with whatever opposes you. Couldn't have built more mines without Mayor West's approval. You should check the town hall for evidence against Bradley. I doubt anyone bothered checking there after the explosion. Be careful, and keep your diary safe. I'm sure you'll need it. Good luck.
Anyone here? All units need to search the mines for casualties. Code Red. Jonathan Bradley kidnapped your sister and attempted to shoot you at the bowling club. Bradley has caused this entire town pain, but he's friends with Mayor West, so he has carte blanche to do whatever he wants. I can't take your word, but I can take your diary as evidence. That bullet mark is pretty convincing, but I wish you had hard evidence that Bradley broke the law. Anyway, you're free to go, but contact me if you find anything.
Whoever wrote in my diary, you were right. The mine's exploded. I'm sure it's Bradley's fault, but I need proof. Am I really expecting someone to answer me? I read too much sci-fi.
You're alive! I can help. I think I know where to find some evidence.
Another reporter here to cash in on our tragedy. You didn't listen, did you? This is your last chance to escape. If the ghosts of the miners get you, they won't let you go.
Who are you, sir? Sir?
Thank you for electing me mayor of Asheville. From now on, my primary goal is solving this town's problems. And I promise. Thank you for electing me mayor of Asheville.
Be still. I'll take you to Mr. Bradley and let him decide what to do with you. What the...
Where'd you find this? It's enough evidence to arrest Bradley and give Mayor West a no-confidence vote. I'll go to Bradley's mansion. I know what this means to you. All right, you can come along. Give it up, Mr. Bradley. We have proof that the explosion was your fault.
If I see even one cop move closer, I'll kill her.
We have a hostage situation. I try to find another door. He's capable of anything. So don't try anything crazy.
Do you see where your prying got you? If you'd stayed out of my business, you wouldn't be in this situation. Mr. Lawson, put your gun down. I know you. You wouldn't hurt a fly. I'm sure you can see that you made a big deal out of nothing. You say I'm ruining Asheville, but I've brought it to life. I've created more jobs, new buildings, infrastructure, roads, tourism. But I'm treated like a criminal. You're just a couple of small-time activists. No one will remember you.
Can't stay there forever!
are you hoping to dig up? It's been 15 years. Just accept the official version. Leave the past buried.
Car trouble? If you're going to Asheville, I can give you a lift. It's not far. My name's Robert Lawson. I'm a local historian. What's yours?